to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about everything that we know so far about the songs in Encanto written by the amazing Lin-Manuel Miranda. There are 8 original songs in the movie and we only know the names of 4. The first song is the opening number, which is called The Family Madrigal. It is sung by Mirabel and it is the fastest song in Disney history. Also, it was inspired by Belle, which is the opening to Beauty and the Beast. Mirabel sings it after the neighborhood children beg her to tell them about her magical family, which she does at length in a musical number that introduces the family members and their powers. She also tries to avoid mentioning that she is the only non-magical member of the family, but it quickly becomes evident and she is the object of their sympathy and pity. Disney has uploaded 35 seconds of the song on YouTube and I haven't been able to stop listening. I can't play it for you here because of copyright, but I will put a link in the description down below. You can see from the title of this video that the song is sung by Stephanie Beatrice and Olga Mildice. Olga is best known for playing Abuela Claudia in the Heights, and I presume that she is providing the singing voice for the grandmother. The second song is called We Don't Talk About Bruno, and it takes place in the first 30 minutes of the film. It is an addictive tango involving multiple characters. Fun fact, Bruno's name was actually chosen by Lin from several options so that he could use the lyric of Bruno No No for this song. The song begins when Peppa breaks the rule of not talking about Bruno, telling how his visions ruined her wedding day, not to mention the lives of the entire city. Disney revealed a color script for this song, and it seems that Bruno's predictions caused Peppa to stress out, resulting in rain on her wedding day. There is also a lot of green imagery surrounding Bruno, suggesting that there is some sort of connection between him and the green glowing glass pieces from the trailer. This song has a lot of dancing, so Disney brought in choreographer Jamil Sims and dance consultant Kai Martinez to help them out. They did reference choreography for the film, which would be filmed from every single angle with skirts on and off, so that the animators could understand the leg movement and footwork. In this picture, you can see a section of the song featuring Mirabel and Dolores, who I presume hears people talking about Bruno all the time because she has super hearing. The music of this song is very quiet and Dolores can hear everything. Because of this, she is quieter and has cat-like movement. Now the press have already seen this song and they love it. It comes up in like every interview, so I'm really pumped to see it. The third song is Surface Pressure and it is sung by Mirabel's older sister, Louisa. It is an energetic reggaeton where Louisa sings about not always being as strong as she appears. It is about how her having all this responsibility is so hard and how behind the scenes it is a struggle. It was one of the first songs written for the film and it really influenced Louisa's character. It will feature big comedy, huge fantasy and dancing donkeys. Some shots in the trailer I believe are from this song and if you want some more info I highly recommend checking out my trailer breakdown. The fourth song is Colombia Mi Encanto, which was played in both trailers for the film. It is one of the 2 songs sung entirely in Spanish. It will be performed by Colombian singer-songwriter Carlos Fives, and it is a celebration of the magical diversity of Colombia. This song made its debut on Dancing with the Stars when Suni Lee and Pro Sasha Faba danced the salsa to it. That leaves 4 mystery songs, and now I'm going to give my theories about what these songs could be. Firstly, we know that there is another song in the film entirely in Spanish. I presume that this is the song that Byron Howard is describing in this interview.
He also wrote a song in the film that's so poignant and beautiful and sounds like it could be a folk song from 100 years ago.
Secondly, we know some details about the last song of the film, which will be an ensemble number. Charisse Castro-Smith said that the last song of the movie is pretty extraordinary. Lin really was able to combine lots of different themes from the entire movie into that one song, and it's just an amazing ensemble piece, so I really love that one. Thirdly, there is a possibility that Bruno will have a rap solo song, as voice actor John Leguizamo has stated that he raps in the film, but I think that it is more likely that he will rap during We Don't Talk About Bruno or another ensemble number. Fourthly, I think that we will get an Isabella song. We already know we are getting a song to deepen the character of Louisa, so I think we will get one for Isabella as well. And finally, I really feel that Mirabel will get another solo song in addition to the Family Madrigal. It will probably be an I Want song, and I'm guessing she will want a magical gift. Anyway, that is all for today. Like this video if you liked it, and please subscribe. It would mean so much to me. Bye now and have a magical day!